Come on, we can... this. I know we can.
Managed to destroy all three keepers. Very impressive. You managed to destroy all three keepers. Very impressive. Yes. Please follow me. Keep watch for Dernevir. With the prison's barrier down, he's almost certain to investigate. The Elder Scroll is just... Elder Scroll is just a bit further. Follow me and stay close. Keep your eye. managed to destroy all three keepers? Very impressive. Yes. Please follow me. Keep watch for Durnavir. With the prison's barrier down, he's almost certain to investigate. The Elder Scroll is just a bit further.
Come on, we can do this. I know we can.
Keep your eyes open.
I could be doing this alone. The better. I found my mother alive. We'll
The Elder Scroll is just a bit further. Quickly.
I'm glad you're here. I don't think I could be doing this alone.
Quickly, this way. Quickly, this way. The Elder Scroll is just a bit further. Quickly,
I can't believe
this way.
We found my mother. Well, you know what I mean. The better. I can't believe we found my mother. Well, you know what I mean. I can't believe we found my mother alive. You know what I mean. Barrier should be gone. Let's head back.
managed to destroy all three keepers? Very impressive. Yes. Please follow me. Keep watch for Durnavir. With the prison's barrier down, he's almost certain to investigate. The Elder Scroll is just a bit further.
Thank you.
astonishment, but I never thought I'd witness the death of that dragon. Volumes written on Durnavir allege that he can't be slain by normal means. It appears they were mistaken. Unless... the soul of a dragon is as resilient as its owner's scaly hide. It's possible that your killing blow has merely displaced Durnavir's physical form while he reconstitutes himself. Minutes? Hours? Years? I can't even begin to guess. I suggest we don't wait around to find out. Now, let's get you the Elder Scroll, and you can be on your way.
She's leading us to the scroll.
I'm glad you're here. I don't think I could be doing this alone.
Now that you've retrieved the Elder Scroll, you should be on your way. I have no choice. As I told you before, I'm a daughter of Cold Harbor. If I return to Tamriel, that increases Harkon's likelihood of bringing the tyranny of the Sun to fruition. I appreciate your concern for me, but Serana is all that I care about. You must keep her safe at all costs. Remember that Harkon is not to be trusted. No matter what he promises, he'll deceive you in order to get what he wants. And promise me you'll keep my daughter safe. She's the only thing of value I have left.
I wish you could find it.
Did you have... anything to ask before you depart? Even if I could, it would only serve to hinder your efforts. Harkon would likely sense my return to Tamriel. The last thing you need right now is a trail for him to follow. Like Serana, I am the daughter of Cold Harbor, a vampire offspring of Molag Bal. My presence in Tamriel would simply double the risk that Harkon could complete the prophecy. The only way I'd even consider returning to Tamriel was if Harkon were not only to fail, but to be destroyed. You must understand. He's no longer the man I married all that time ago. He's obsessed. Insane. Everyone around him fears him as they would a rabid dog. For all of this to end, he must die.
Stay your weapons. I would speak with you, Quanari. Cursed, not dead. Doomed to exist in this form for eternity. Trapped between Laas and Enoch. Between life and death. I believe in civility among seasoned warriors, and I find your ear worthy of my words. My claws have rendered the flesh of innumerable foes, but I have never once been felled on the field of battle. I therefore honor name you Quanarin, or Vanquisher in your tongue. Your words do me great honor. My desire to speak with you was born from the result of our battle, Quanarin. I merely wish to respectfully ask a favor of you. For countless years I've roamed the Soul Cairn in unintended service to the Ideal Master. Before this, I roamed the skies above Tamriel. I desire to return there. I fear that my time here has taken its toll upon me. I share a bond with this dreaded place. If I ventured far from the Soul Cairn, my strength would begin to wane until I was no more. I will place my name with you and grant you the right to call my name from Tamriel. Do me this simple honor, and I will fight at your side as your Graze Mazen, your ally, and teach you my thune. Trivial in your mind, perhaps. For me, it would mean a great deal. I don't require an answer, Quanarin. simply speak my name to the heavens when you feel the time is right. There was a time when I called Tamriel my home. But those days have long since passed. The Dova roamed the skies, vying for their small slices of territory that resulted in immense and ultimately fatal battles. I was, but unlike some of my brethren, I sought solutions outside the norm in order to maintain my superiority. I began to explore what the Dova call Elok Dilan, the ancient forbidden art that you call necromancy. The Ideal Masters assured me that my powers would be unmatched, that I could raise legions of the undead. In return, I was to serve them as a keeper until the death of the one who calls herself Valerica. I discovered too late that the Ideal Masters favor deception over honor and had no intention of releasing me from my binding. They had control of my mind, but fortunately they couldn't possess my soul. Free? No. I have been here too long, Quanarin. The Soul Cairn has become a part of what I am. I can never fully call Tamriel my home again, or I would surely perish. I only hope that you will allow me the precious moments of time there through your call. In my language, the Quanarin is the vanquisher, the one who has bested a fellow Dova in battle. Forgive me. My instinct was to grant you this title. I am uncertain why. Perhaps one day it will become clear to both of us.
Yes?
I wasn't even sure we'd make it out of there in one piece. I know this sounds weird, but while we were back in the Soul Care, I was kind of scared that the Ideal Masters wouldn't do anything, really. Trap us there, for one. I wouldn't like to be a hostage for eternity.